Today's message is the fifth one of a series talking about a new man's living.
所以今天的信息呢，是我们一连串的，这是第五次的讲到新人的生活。
I have shared about four messages before related to new man's living.
那么过去我已经讲过是关于这个新人的事情。
I want to give it a very short review, okay. And then I will talk about the fifth one.
那么我首先呢还是要复习一下，然后我们再来谈第五个。
The first one that I shared, I don't know whether you remember, we had a cremation ceremony.
记不记得我第一个信息里面讲的时候，后来我们做了一个动作，我们去把一些东西烧掉。
Because according to Romans chapter 6, our old man has died and buried, and our new man lives with the Lord.
所以呢，我们知道罗马书很清楚告诉我们说，我们那个旧的人哈是已经与基督同死了、钉死了、埋葬了，现在是新的生命在我们里面。
We are not only Jesus, not only died for us.He also died as us.
所以耶稣不仅是为我们而死，他是成为你我而死。
So when he died and buried, your old man also have died and buried.
所以当耶稣呢，他死了，他也埋葬的时候，表示你我的旧人也跟着一起死了，埋葬了。
When Jesus was raised from the dead,Our new man was born again with him.
那么，当耶稣从死里复活的时候，我们里面的新人同样的是复活了。
So therefore, Romans chapter 6, verse 11, we already read before that Paul said, "Therefore, count yourself dead to sin."
所以呢，后来呢，在罗马书是他说，你当看你的旧人是死。
But alive to God in Jesus Christ.
可是在神的面前却是活着的。
Do you believe that your old man has died?
你真的相信你的旧人死了吗？
Can you raise your hand if you truly believe? But when you look at yourself, you look into the mirror, you feel that my old man is still very active.
可是有时候你照照镜子的时候，你看看自己，好像我那个旧人还是还很活跃的样子。
And this has been a mystery and a puzzle for me for some so many years.
对我来讲呢，这个是困惑了不是数十年。
And I sympathize with Paul in Romans chapter 7. The things I want to do, I cannot do. The things I don't want to do, I do.And so miserable. I'm so miserable.
那么我就很同情保罗，我也能够认同保罗在罗马书第七章讲说，我想是要做的事，我偏偏不去做；不想做的事，怎么偏偏去做？他说我好同情他。
Who has this experience?
你们有多少人有这种经历啊？ Yeah. 我们都有过。
So you feel that my old man is still very actively alive.
所以因为这样我们就想说那我旧人一定还是活生生的、啊、不然为什么会这样呢
But I want to assure you that your old nature has died.
但是我要跟你说而且很有就是保证你说你的旧的那个老我已经死了。
The proof of your old man dead is not looking at yourself, it's looking at the cross.
所以你怎么证明说这个旧人是死了呢？你不是来看看你检查你自己的改变多少，而是你要看看十字架为你成就了什么。
But why you still sin?
可是那为什么我们还会犯罪
？Because that's not your sin nature, that your sin habit.
那我上次提过了说，说那个不是我们的罪性使得我们继续犯罪，而是以我们的罪的习惯还在。
Because your new man is still not strong enough, so by default, sometimes you fall into sin.
因为你的新人呢还不够长成哈，或者说那个身量还不够健康，因此呢很容易又掉到罪的习惯。
And the enemy can lie to you, say, see, look at you, God's word is not true.
那么这种情况，仇敌就来控告你的说，你看上帝讲的那个根本做不到，或者说那个话是不可靠的。
And you are still 100% sinner.
然后就让你相信你还是100%是个罪人。
And you and I are so humble when we pray, we say, Lord, forgive me, I'm a sinner.
那我们也就很谦卑地说，主啊，赦免我这个罪人。
That's the reason why Paul said, count yourself dead to sin.
所以保罗就告诉我们说，我们当看我们这个人已经像罪是死。
And God said, I'm not doing anger management. Your anger, old man, is dead and buried.
那神就要告诉我们说，其实我不是要来帮助你们怎么学习怎么样的来manage 你的那个你的怒气哈，因为你那个容易生气的旧人已经死了埋葬了。
I want to teach you how your new man can live.
我乃是要教你，让你那个新人要怎么样来活出来。
When you continue to be so secure in my love, in my love, in my majesty, in my abundance, then gradually the anger, the fear, the inferior complex, and the depression will subside and will decrease.
当你真的是能够让我帮助你。那个去认识那个新人，帮助你的新人成长的时候，那你所有的那些焦虑、害怕、自卑，或者是怒气，那些问题就越来越没有办法影响你。
And you will realize that you were gradually not so easy to be irritated.
那你就会发现说，哎，我这个人现在真的不太容易被挑动生气了。
Your speech will become more soft.
那你讲话的口气也越来越好。
And you have more peace.
你自己也会越来越有平安。
And your wife can see that, and your children can also notice that.
那么你的妻子、你的孩子都会注意到，哎，不一样了。
And they are very happy.
他们很开心。
But someone is not happy. You know?
只有一个不高兴的，你猜是谁
？Satan is not happy.
就是撒旦。
So we share. This is very important. That's why I repeat.
因为很重要，所以我就跟你们重复。
So first, the old man has died.
第一个就是说，旧人已经死了。
And the second, we share about the beginning of a new life, new man living is that you are aware of God's presence.
那么我们讲到说好，那你怎么知道？这个新人的生活里面，第一件事情是你开始注意到神的同在，或者渴望神的同在。
In the past, before you become a Christian, you don't even know that God exists.
在我们没有信主以前，我们连神存在这件事情我们都不相信。
We just believe we come from the ape, and the ape come from the amoeba and so forth.
我们有可能是相信进化了，我想说我是猿猴变的，猿猴又是那些amoeba变的。
But after I became a Christian, I realized that God said, "I will be with you," and I know that God is with me.
所以信主以后，我知道，you know, 就是说不但有神，而且神与我同在。
So I restrained myself from doing something that was embarrassing to the Lord.
所以我就告跟现，就是说，我就不去做那些会让上帝觉得很不好的事情。
I'm aware of His presence, so I don't some of the things I don't do anymore.
因为我知道神随时都在跟我在一起，所以我就不去做那些他不会喜欢的事。
I told myself, others may, I may not.
那我就跟自己说，别人可以这样做，但是我选择不这样做。
Some of the things.Others may do, but I may not.
有些事情别人可能还是这样做，可是我就选择不做。
When Kevin was in the primary school, people said his classmates said, "Why don't you do things, mischievous things with us?" And Kevin said, "I'm a Christian."
那我记得凯文小学二年级的时候，他的那些朋友就问他说：“哎，我们这些捣蛋，你为什么不加入我们？”凯文说：“ 我是基督徒啊。
And thirdly, the message that I shared before was about God. We know that God loves us.
那么第三点就是说，我们呢知道天父爱我们。
So we are so sure of God's love, so we can trust Him. And since we can trust Him, we can believe in His word.
那么因为我们确定了神是如此爱我们，所以我们就能相信他，以及因此也能够相信他所说的话。
So I realized faith is not abstract. Faith is actually full of content and solid.
所以我就明白说，其实信心不是一个很抽象的，好像说哦，你就是信就好了，而是是一个相当的有把握的，而且是很丰富的内容的。
My faith stand firmly on God's love and His almighty power.
所以我的信心是什么？是站立在神对我的那种神自己的那种爱，以及他的能力
大能
大能。
So when my children were small, I said, jump.
所以孩子很小的时候，他们在高的地方，我就叫他跳下来，他就跳下来。
Where did that faith come from?
他们怎么会有这种信心
？Come from love.
就是因为他知道爸爸爱他。
And that's our new life.
这是我们的新的生命。
The more our new life lives, the more we know His love, and the more we are sure of His word.
所以我们越知道神是如此，他是爱的话，我们就越能够信任他。
And the fourth message I shared before, let's talk about your as a new man, your life may look quite abnormal to some people.
那我上次又分享一段说，作为成为一个新人，对某一些人来看你的时候，他觉得你有点点不正常。
Right?
有没有
？I mentioned about Noah making an ark. That's pretty abnormal.
那么，比如我用的例子就是说，挪亚在造方舟的时候看起来很不正常。
And Moses had a conversation in the wilderness with this burning bush.
那摩西呢，在那个旷野的时候，竟然跟那个会烧火的荆棘在讲话，这也很奇怪。
And we talk about the mind and the spirit.
那我们也在，我也分享了说，我们人有头脑，我们也有灵。
We in the past we passed when we face something, we pass through our mind first.
那么在过去呢，我们的习惯都是遇到任何的情况，我们第一就先从头脑去想。
But as a new man.You gradually process through your spirit first.
那么，但是成为一个新人，在基督里的新人的时候，你会开始从你的灵去领受去然后去决定。
You discern whether it's from the Lord.
你会分辨说这是出于神吗
？And your mind discern whether it's logic or not logic.
那么你的头脑又会告诉说这个是合理还是不合逻辑？
When you want to dismiss it because it's not logic, then your spirit said, "Hey, wait a minute. If this God, then He is beyond our logic."
所以呢，当你觉得说呀，可是这个很不合逻辑的时候，你就很想不理他的时候，可能圣灵又提醒你说，如果是出于神，即使不合你的逻辑。
The other day we had a dinner at my house, and before that I was preparingA fish. That's Helen's daddy gave us a fish. I was cleaning.
那么在有一天晚上呢，就是在预备晚餐，所以呢，我就在清一个鱼头，那是那个金童给我们的。
And I look at the fish with a scale and with gill and with everything so fascinated, amazingly made. And in my mind, I say.People believe that this a random by evolution and randomly come up with a fish like this.
那我就一面清那个鱼，我就看到这个鱼的结构，这是这么奇妙。但我就想说，可是人却宁可相信说这些都是演化进化来的。
But because I'm a new man in the Lord, so my mind is changed.
因为我现在知道我在基督里已经是个新人，所以我的看法已经改变了。
Not confined to the worldly system.
已经不是在被世界的一套的系统来辖制了。
And I know that there is a creator, and our being is not from a Big Bang theory.
那我知道有一位创造的主。然后我们并不是因为所谓的他们叫大爆炸理论以后所生出来，所以演化成为的一个人。
So, we have all shared about these messages before.
那这些我过去都提过了。
Today I want to go to the new man living number five.
那我今天呢要讲第五个部分。
And the topic is that speaking.The new language of heaven.
那么，这题目呢，我就是定说叫，学会说天国的语言。
I want to make it three points.
我就讲三个点。
Sometimes I didn't mention about the points, but today I want to mention about the three points.
那么，有时候我并没有提有几点，但今天我就让你知道有三个点。
First point, as a new man, you change.From negative to positive.
那第一点就是说，成为新人的话，你会从负面转变成为正面，积极正面。
As a newborn, new man, you come from the world system into the God system.
因为成为新人呢，其实是说你脱离了那个世界的那个系统，你现在进入到神国度的系统里。
We live in this world, and around us, the culture is normally negative.
那么我们所生活的这个世界里，往往我们周遭的环境充满都是负面的。
On Earth, we tend to focus on problems.
那么在地上的时候呢，你很容易就看到问题。
And full of negative, full of hatred, fear, anger, judgment.Depression and so forth.
所以你就听一听周遭的事情，你就会觉得充满的都是很多的论断、批评，很多的这些负面的这种说辞。
People say, "Aren't you worried?"
然后人家就说你不担心吗
？You don't feel angry?
你难道听到这你不生气吗
？You say, "Yeah, I should feel angry."
我就想说，哎，我应该是这样。
How come I didn't feel angry?
为什么我却不生气
？Yeah, he is right. I should feel angry. Then you become angry.
如果他里面想，哦，他讲的是对，哎，我应该生气，然后你真的就生气了。
But now, as a new man, you can think, you can see things from the heavenly perspective.
现在成为新人以后，你发现你可以从神、从天上的角度来看很多事情。
And from heaven, you see a lot of possibilities.
你从天上看的时候，看到很多不一样的可能性。
You can dismiss the worry.
那你能够将你那些本来担忧的事都不再担忧了。
I practiced this morning.
我今天早上就在练习这个，操练这个。
We had a furniture coming in.
Yeah, 有个姐妹要把家具给我。
And I said, not here yet. I have to go to church.
那我就紧张了，我想说，怎么到现在还没有来？那我待会儿要上教堂怎么办
？And I thought to myself, I should tell Monica. We should call and make sure.
那他就想到哦，那赶快去跟许师母讲，然后赶快叫他再打电话，确定他们一定在几点以前要把做事情做完。
But it came to me that I'm going to preach about positive today.
然后有个念头就是说，你今天不是要讲这个信息吗？要保持很积极正面吗
？And I shouldn't worry.
那你干嘛担心呢
？So I pray to the Lord. I said, Lord, I'll keep my mouth shut.
我就跟主说，好，我什么都不说。
And I want to make sure that confirm this, so I already jot down all this in my diary.
那为什
么 you can look.
Yeah, 那我就把这个写在我的日记上。
And I said, Lord, I want to see how you do it.
我就跟主说，主啊，你不会误事。
So immediately, Monica got a message. She said, "It will arrive in half an hour."
然后我就跟他说，我根本不知道他在做什么。可是我就跟他说，哦。 他们打电话来说三十分钟以后就到。
But it didn't arrive in 30 minutes.
但事实上没有三十分钟就到。
The workers went to lunch.
因为他们说肚子饿去吃饭。
But we managed to come here.
但是我们没有迟到，我们就还是
早到。Before 2 o'clock.
我们两点以前就到了。
Can you imagine that? So, as a new man, you know you can trust the Lord, and you have the possibilities.
当你成为新人的时候，你知道你可以信靠神。信靠就是你不用像以前一样操这个心操那个心。
When you read the Bible, four Gospels, Jesus, many times he said, others, you have heard others say this, but I tell you. So Jesus thought is what is different from what average people say.
你知道看四福音书哈，就是看常常会看到耶稣对门徒说，他说你们听到一般人是这样这样这样说的。但是我告诉你，啊，就是说，写明说，耶稣的看法、想法是跟世俗是不一样的。
So God, Jesus sees things differently. So we are Christians. We are His children. We should also see things differently.
呀，因为耶稣是这样，那我们既然是他的孩子，我相信我们应该都学他，也有个不一样的看见。
In the past, we speak.Earthly language, but now we see heavenly language.
过去我们都是讲地上的话，现在我们要学习讲天国的话。
After you come to the United States for a little while, then your English will improve.
你来美国一段时间，你就发现你的英文有进步。
Your young people are born here, so of course you have a good start. So your English is, we can never catch up.
那么年轻人因为生长在这里，所以他们学英文呢就是很自然的事情。
We are born into heavenly kingdom.
那神已经把我们生在基督的那个天国的那个国度里。
So church should become a heavenly language learning center.
所以教会应该变成天国语言的学习中心。
And together.We have different perspective, and we speak different languages.
所以，因为我们有不同的看见，我们可以说不同的语言。
Because our identity belongs there. We are in the world, but we don't belong. We are not of the world.
虽然我们是生活在这世界，可是我们不属于这个世界，不属于这个世界的系统。
Right?
对。
Can you learn that? When the spies went into check on the land of Canaan.
当那十二个那个探子去查视那个地方哈迦南地的时候。
And the people from the world perspective said, "Oh, these people here, we cannot attack them because they are so strong. Their cities are fortress and so forth. We look at ourselves as like."Grasshopper, and according to their view, we are also like grasshopper.
那十个探子呢？他们就是带着地上的那种观点，他们回来的报告是说，哇，那个地方是很好，但是那里的居民太大太强壮，他们的城市也是那么样的坚固。他们看我们，就是说，他说我们呢。觉得我们在他们面前，他们是巨人，我们就像那个小蚱蜢一样。然后他看我们也差不多是如此。
But Caleb looked from different perspective.
但是迦勒不这样投，不这样看。
You remember, Caleb said, "If the Lord is pleased with us, He will lead us into the land."
他说：“主如果喜悦我们，他必有办法把我们带到那个地方去。”
So.If you have different perspective, the impossibility becomes possible.
如果你能够有一个不一样的看见的话，那些所有不可能的事，现在变成可能了。
So my first point is that as a new man, your perspective, you can change from negative to positive.
所以成为一个新人呢，你这个人会改变的。过去你可能很悲观、很负面，现在你变得很积极。很那个正面。
And the second point is, as a new man, you can step into the impossible.
这第二点就是说，成为新人以后呢，你就会进入那些你过去认为这是不可能的这样的一个领域。
Those who believe that it's possible can also step into the impossible and become possible.
那么过去呢，那些不能相信的那些人呢，他现在有机会可以去从那个觉得哎呀这都不可能，那不可能，而去经历那个不可能成为可能。
A lot of testimonies you can share.
我想我们有说不完的见证。
The heater of the baptistry didn't work, right?
比如说好多年前，好久以前，我说当我们要受洗的时候，发现那个热那个什么烧热水的东西不能做工。
And I command the heater to work.
那我就命令他要得医治。
I put my hand on the heater. I said.Be healed.
那我就把手放在那里，我就说你要得医治。
You know, sometimes the ear ring came to me, and immediately I said, "In the name of Jesus, be gone."
有时候我就会好像有那种叫耳鸣哈，就会临到的时候，我现在都知道，就只要奉主的名叫他离开，他就离开。
If you believe, then you can step into the impossible.
你如果相信，你就会进入那个不可能。而使他成为可能的那样的一个境界。
2 million Israelites perished in the wilderness, and only 2 people entered. Caleb entered, Joshua entered.
那200万这些以色列的百姓都死在旷野里，只有那个 Caleb 跟约书亚带着那个年轻的一代进入。
The secret is in Number chapter 14.
那么这个秘密呢是在
民数记十四节。Can someone read for me? Number 14 verse 24. 我们来看一下。This is a very powerful Bible verse. Number 14 verse 24.I'll give you the micro. Anybody? Read for me.
你们读出来。
Numbers
14:24. But my servant Caleb, because he has a different spirit and has followed me fully,I will bring it to the land into which he went, and his descendants shall possess it.
Only my servant Caleb, Bible said, God said, because he has another, what? Another spirit.
他说，只有我的仆人加勒，他另有一个心智。
And follow me wholeheartedly, I will bring him into the land he went to.
所以呢，因为他全心信靠我，所以我会带他进入我要他们进入的地方。
Let me ask you, what is another spirit?
什么叫做另有一个心智呢？
What is another spirit? Another thinking.
就是有一个不同的想法看见。
Another perspective.
他有不同的看法。
Speak another language.
他也讲不一样的语言。
Which is a heavenly language.
他讲的是天国的语言。
And another spirit because he knows God, so he can trust God.
因为他认识神，所以他觉得他可以信任神。
It's amazing, huh? Another spirit.
是有另一个心智。
So actually, spiritual realm is more than what our eyes can see.
因为我们知道说灵界是超越我们肉眼所可以看得到的。
As a new man, you can train your perspective and you can train your language. Not only see what you can see with your naked eyes, but you see with your spiritual eyes.
所以作为一个新人呢，我们是可以训练我们，所以使得我们不单是用肉眼看。我们也可以从灵里面或者灵眼去看。
His way is higher than our ways.
因为神的道路是高过人的道路。
And if we see him, we can trust him.
如果我们可以看见他，我们就能够信任他。
Hebrews chapter 11 said, without faith, you cannot please God.
那么希伯来书十一章说，人没有信心是不能啊讨神喜悦的。
So people say, that's foolish, that's crazy.
那么大部分人就跟他说，你那样做法是太荒唐了。
That's not logical.
一点不合理逻辑。
That's impossible.
也是做不到的，不可能的。
I say, I agree, it's crazy.
我就说是没有错，是听起来似乎很疯狂。
But I'm talking about heavenly language.
但是我用的是天国的语言。
You know, somebody said, faith is the currency of God's kingdom.
那么也有人这样说，他说其实信心就是天国里面的钞票。
Those who have faith, those who believe, can step into God's promise.
那些相信的就能够进入得着神一切的应许。
Then you can experience God, you can encounter God, and you, through your experience, then you are affirmed that God's word is truth.
所以呢，这样子你会经历神，然后又会遇见神。透过这些无数的这样的经历以后，那你的信心一定是更加的坚定。
Then your faith, your spiritual life will be upgraded.
那么你发现你整个属灵生活就一直不断的被提升。
So in heaven, there is all possibilities.
那么在天国那里来说，那是各式各样的这种可能性都会有。
So let's train ourselves. We said, as a new man, negative language is not acceptable.
那么让我们来训练自己，跟自己说，成为新人，我就不接纳那些负面的这些的语言。
Can we train ourselves?
我们可以这样来训练自己呢？
Negative language is not acceptable.
就是我们不再来接受容让这些负面的言语在我们里面。
We can do better than that.
我们一定可以做得比这个更好
，right？
对。
So number three.
那第三点呢
？As a new man, we learn language, and heavenly language is not too difficult to learn.
就是说，天国的语言，我们作为新人就要学新的言语嘛，哈。可是天国的言语其实不是那么难学的。
So three points.Number one is, as a new man, you change from negative to positive.
所以三点，第一点就是说，成为新人，我们就要从负面的变为正面的。
The second point is, as a new man, you can step into the impossible.
那第二点是说，成为新人，你就可以进入那所谓的不可能的领域。
And the third point.Heavenly language is not too difficult to learn.
那第三点就告诉你说，天国的语言不难学。
Okay, I teach you some heavenly language.
我来教你们几个天国语言。
You repeat after me.
你就跟着我讲。
I am special.
你说我是很特别的。
I'm his precious treasure.
我是他的宝贝 ，treasure's possession.
Treasure possession, yes.
Yes.
I am beautiful.
我是很美丽的。
I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
我是fearfully, yeah. 受造奇妙可畏。
My grandchildren love to say this. God is in good mood.
我的孙子很喜欢讲说，上帝心情很好，一直很好。
Can you say God is in good mood?
God is in good mood.
And He loves me all the time.
He loves me. 他永远爱我。
Nothing can separate me from His love.
没有任何事可以让我跟他的爱隔绝的。
And one thing is very important.
还有一个重要。
With God, nothing is impossible.
那么，在神，凡事都能。
When I see the four-year-old reciting this, I'm excited.
我看到四岁小孩这样背这样讲，我说哇，我好兴奋。
And I saw him in I have here in New Jersey.
I have EG,
and I saw him lay hands and so little, lay hands and pray for healing. Lord. Lord heal him because he believes nothing is impossible.
当我们看到他们这小小的四五岁的孩子按着手为人祷告的时候，他们很单纯，他们相信神会做事。
And when you face difficult situation, you can train yourself and to speak heavenly language.
当你遇到困难的时候，你要训练自己说：“我不要我救人的想法，我要讲出天国的话。”
In the past, you say, "Oh Lord, why me?"
在以前，你可能说：“主啊，怎么会是我呢？遇到这个麻烦。”
And you practice new languages, talk to yourself, say, "Stop it."
你就跟自己说：“嘿，不要这样子。”
When husband really irritates you and he is so unlovable.
当你的丈夫是让你很生气
，and you practice the new language，
你就学习，你就练习你的天国语言。
You tell yourself，
你就跟自己说
，love him，
爱他。
And when you lost your job and you are depressed，
那你说，哎呀，我公司把我这个革职了，你很难过。
You practice your new language，
你就练习你的新的语言。
You tell yourself，
你跟自己说。
Get one.
你就是再找一个。
And when at work, your colleagues, they at the lunch time, they all sit together and talk and badmouth about the boss.
那么当你在公司上班的时候，你发现你的同事他们常常聚在一起，就在那批评老板。
And you practice heavenly language.
那你就练习天国的语言。
You said.Our boss is not perfect.
也就是说，你心里说，是，你就跟他们说，老板的确他不完美。
He has his shortcomings.
他的确有他一些的缺点、短处。
He does have his blind spot.
可能也有一些盲点。
But is there anything I can help him?
那有没有事情是我能够帮助他的呢？
And you ask God for wisdom, and you try to do things truly to help his short-term.
那么你就祷告，你说神啊，你给我一些智慧，让我知道如何去补足他的缺点。
And you truly help your boss.
那你真的就这样去帮助他。
Later.
后来。
When there is something happen, the boss tell your colleague say to go to see Joe.
那么以后呢，就是说老板就会遇到什么事情，人家有什么难处，就说啊，你去找那个某某人，因为他很好。
Because you practice heavenly language.
因为你就这样操练你的天国语言。
And you become more attractive to people around you.
那么你这样子的话，周围的人就会注意到，然后他们就被你吸引。
Right? Is a positive one attract people or the negative?
你想一个积极正面的人跟一个负面的人哪一个比较受吸引啊受欢迎
it is because you become attractive to people because the Jesus lives in you he attracts a lot of people
是你之所以这样是因为耶稣住在你里面而耶稣使你积极正面自然就会吸引人
isn't that wonderful you become more attractive to people
那你就变成对别人来说你真的是越来越能够吸引人，人家会喜欢你。
And you think is that me?
你说哇，这是我吗
？Why did I change?
我什么时候变了
？Because the new man is growing in you.
为什么？那是因为那个新人在你里面在长大了。
When you go to school,
你上学的时候
，the classmate was neglected by all and despised by all.
假设说有个同学，大家都不喜欢他，都不理他。
And you get yourself courage. You bring your lunchbox and sit next to him.
那你就鼓起勇气来，拿起你的午餐去坐在他旁边。
You become heavenly. You speak heavenly language.
这样就是在说天国的话。
Isn't that wonderful?
这样很美吧。
God's purpose.This is conclusion. God's purpose
is that
He caused everything to work for the good of those who love Him.
就是说，神使所有的事情、万事都互相效力， 是要让那些爱他的人都得好处。
God calls everything, including bad thing and good thing.
那么所有的万事是包括所有的好的事情、不好的事情。
For the good of those who love him.
就是那一些是来帮助、来得益处、那些爱他的人得好处的。
What is the good? What is the good thing?
那么得什么好处啊？
So next verse, verse 29 said, "For those God foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the likeness of His Son."
那么就是那一些神早就选召，而且呢，能够
他预先所知道的人，就预先定下他。效法他儿子的模样。The good thing is that he wants to conform you and me to be like Jesus Christ.
那么得什么好处？其实那个好处就是说，他借着这些事情要让我们越来越像耶稣。
So as a new man, we don't be defeated by negative language anymore.
所以成为新人呢，我们不要就是被那些负面的语言来打败。
When the storm comes, you just meditate. Oh, Jesus took a nap in the boat. I can take a nap.
当你在风暴的时候，你就想到说，哎，耶稣在风暴的时候，他是在睡觉，那很放松。你就不紧张了。
So you don't have to be panic in advance.
你就不要就开始紧张了。
And gradually, you can see what God sees. You can think what God thinks. You can speak what God speaks.
等你慢慢你就发现，你可以看到神所看到的，说神所要说的话。
And your language is no more unbelief or fear or doubt.
那么你所说出来的话不再是那些信不来的啦，或者怀疑的，或者是负面的话语。
But it's faith, peace, power, authority, and sensor.
所以充满的倒是一种有信心，而且很正面的，是有带着能力的。
So every situation you face allow you to encounter God and upgrade you to be more like Jesus.
其实每一个我们遇到的难处呢，其实都是一个机会，让我们来遇见神，然后使我们的生命能够一直的被提升，然后越来越能够像耶稣。
And your life will be fascinating.
那你的生命就真的是很棒很棒了。
And that kind of living is reality, is not a theory anymore.
现在能够活出这样的生命，不再是一个梦想或者是不可能，而是真的可以的。
Is that wonderful?
这样不是很棒吗？
New man's living.
这就是新人活出来的样子。
Because your old is dead.
因为旧人已经死了。
And God is now not counseling your old man, but train your new man.
现在神呢，他不再去辅导你那个旧人的感觉那些问题，他现在是训练你这个新人。
And he said, "I will be with you forever. I never forsake you."
他说我永远与你同在，我绝对不会遗弃你，离弃你的，我一定会帮助你的。
And we learn his language. We live his life.
我们就开始学会说天国的语言，活出耶稣基督的样子。
And we change.
我们就改变了。
And people around us see us change.
那么周遭的人会看到，哎，他真的改变了。
Isn't that wonderful?
很棒，他真的改变。
Have you seen me change?
你们有没有看见许牧师改变
？I actually realized that I have changed.
那么他发现，呀，是真的有改变。
But I struggled for so many years.
但是我挣扎了很多年。
I was so disappointed with myself because.I'm a new man, I should be dead, but I, chapter 7, I'm still, the things I don't want to do, I do, and so forth. Just like everybody.
那我就觉得很多年来我就很挫折，因为我觉得说，我明明知道我应该是个新人，为什么我还活在第七章呢？像很多人一样。
But I never gave up.
但是我没有放弃。
then I see God's word is true.
那我就发现神的话真的很真实。
I mentioned once, just this conclusion. How heavy is the airplane?
我问你们。
The average weight.
一架飞机。他讲过，一架飞机平均可多少吨？多重？
Anybody remember?
记不记得？
80 ton.
平均来说有八十吨。
Can you believe that 80 ton, this heavy machine, can fly in the air?
我就很难想象哈，八十吨这么重的东西可以飞到天上去。
And most amazing thing is when that machine touched down.
常常就是它下落的时候，这是很精彩，对不对？
So I ask you and myself.Can we trust God's word with a belief that can believe that airplane 80 tons can fly? Just use that faith, then you can trust the Lord, I think, trust His word.
我就是想用个比较具体的，就是说，如果我们能够相信这个八十吨的飞机可以载着我们这样飞到天上又下来的话，用这样的信心来相信神的话，应该是可以的。
So I want to trust His word and speak His word.
所以我要相信他的话语，说出他的话语。
And live a victorious life.
然后做过一个得胜的生活。
And one day when I see Him face to face.
当那一天我见到他面对面的时候。
I will kneel before Him.
我会跪在他的脚前。
And I can feel that He touched my head.
我可以感受到神会怎么做呢？他会触摸我的头。
And He's a good boy.
他说好孩子啊。
Come enjoy Father's happiness.
你进来享受父的快乐吧。
And He showed me, see, I have told you.
他会告诉我说，你看，我不是告诉你了吗？
That's why every time when I worship, I cry. Today I cry a lot.
所以为什么我每次敬拜我都会哭？像今天我又哭了好多次。
Because He saved me and gave me so much.
因为他救了我，而且给我这么多、这么多的礼物。
And I know it's all because His love.
我知道是都是出于他对我的爱。
He wants to conform me into the image of Lord Jesus.
他就是要改变我，一直到把我磨成他爱子耶稣的样子。
He never forget the Adam and Eve He created first.
他一直没忘记当初他造亚当夏娃的时候。
He just want to restore all back to the family and garden of Eden.
所以他就想，他的最大的梦想就是把我们一个一个都生命都恢复了，让我们都能够回到当初好像。被造的那个时候跟他的那种关系。
And I know he is not, he will not be disappointed.
我知道神他不会失望的。
Every one of us will be conformed to the image.
我相信我们每一个人都会被他来转化改变，然后越来越像耶稣。
Our message ends here. You can meditate a little bit upon it, and then we can be.
那我的信息就结束，但是你可以继续的来默想，继续是或者甚至跟神祷告都可以， you know, 就是所以我们
And you, when you are ready, then you can leave.
当你觉得想离开的时候再离开。
Praise the Lord.
赞美主。